Well, hello and welcome back to module 4 of this e-learning MOOC on developing digital skills. Module 4 is all about how to program machines. We've talked a little bit about coding in the last few videos, and now we're going to be having a little think about app development. Now there's lots of different ways that it's possible to develop apps, and in this video I'm going to draw your attention to one or two websites and services which you might find useful to develop apps both yourself and with your students. The first website that I wanted to draw your attention to was the website which is called Apps for Good. Now, Apps for Good is a UK-based charity, but the reason that I'm flagging it up is because it's also starting to grow prominence in other parts of the world, including the United States and lots of parts of Europe. And even if you can't access all of the services on the Apps for Good website, you can still go into the website and access a lot of the materials that are there, and materials which could be used then for your own classes. Now, the most important thing I think about any type of app development is getting young people to think a little bit about why they want to develop the app in the first place. And again, the Apps for Good philosophy tends to do this quite well. Initially, they ask children to go away and to see if they can find a problem that they want to solve. Then they ask the children to go out and carry some market research to make sure that it's not just their problem, that other people also agree that it's a problem which they want to solve as well, and therefore there's a market for it. They're carrying out market research. Once they've done this, there's a lot of brainstorming that goes on in order to develop some kind of solution design in terms of how the app might work in theory. Then, of course, you have to throw in the technicalities of developing an app. Sometimes we want things that just aren't technically possible. So we combine the solution design with the product design before we go on to build and test. Once we've built and test, then probably what we're going to do is create another problem, and then the whole process starts again. So if we're developing an app, these five simple steps can be really useful to get your students into the right mindset. And as I've already mentioned, there's lots of really, really good resources on the Apps for Good website that can be used. It's also a great example where you can go and have a look to see other apps that have been developed by children and young people. These are some of the apps that won the 2014 competition. And they're all designed about solving a real problem. For example, Chore Attack was designed by one of the high schools in Scotland. And the whole idea behind Chore Attack was that it got parents and families and young people who lived in the homes to work as part of a team to tackle household chores. Another one of my favourites is the Pocket Money Pig. The idea of the Pocket Money Pig is for a young person to record how much money they get from their parents in the form of pocket money. But of course, they also record in there, for example, if they've been given a treat from their parents as well. A really, really interesting concept. Lots of the other apps as well are also really, really good, worth a look at, and are good at setting the bar in terms of what is possible if children really put their mind to it. So I'd encourage you to go and have a little look at Apps for Good. The next service I wanted to show you is a service called AppShed. An AppShed is all about creating apps. There's an education version, but there's also a free normal version as well, which is supported by advertising. The great thing about AppShed is you don't need to know any complicated computer programming to develop a web-based app. If you pay, you can also get your app, once it's been developed, into an app store, such as Google Play or the Apple iTunes Store or the Windows Store. The other great thing about AppShed is that there's lots and lots of videos on the AppShed YouTube channel. This again takes young people through the key and important parts of app development, as well as showing you how to use the software itself. So if you're looking for a place to start, where you're looking really to encourage the creativity of design around an app, I would definitely recommend checking out AppShed. As I say, it's a freemium service, but as you progress through the service, there are some costs that are involved. The next website I'm just going to flag is Touch Development. Touch Development comes from Microsoft, but the great part of it is that you can actually create apps for your phone, your tablet, or your laptop. And then once the apps are developed, it's completely cross-platform. It works on iOS, that's Apple devices, Android, Windows, Mac, and of course even Linux. Now, touch development, we think, has got a huge amount of potential in education, and that's why the next video is dedicated to talking to you a little bit about touch development and how you might use it in your classroom. The final thing that I wanted to flag up was a piece of work that I did back in 2013 for Microsoft and also for the Lions Rugby Tour. I was asked to develop an app challenge. And what the app challenge was, is it was a set of video tutorials using design thinking principles to help young people develop an app. And the reason that I'm flagging this up is because this resource is free and you can download it from the Microsoft Educators Network. It really is just about a 4-hour project where young people can go away and they can do all of the thinking around developing an app which they might develop then in real life using a service like Apps for Good or for AppShed. So the resource is there and I'll make sure that I put the link into the community. So, quite a few things to think about in terms of app development. The most important thing though, just like developing any technology service, is making sure that we've thought about why we want to develop it in the first place. Go away and check out Apps for Good, go away, check out AppShed, and also check out my Lions Teamwork Challenge. Hopefully you'll find it useful to be able to use with your students. As I said, the next video is all about touch development.